Hello, my name is Seok Jin Ahm. I'm a professor at Graduate School of Public Administration, Seoul National University. I sincerely welcome you all to the Digital Government Policy and Best Practices Korea course. We have entered a society where we cannot live without the digital. The transition into a contactless society triggered by the COVID-19 pandemic is an inevitable trend of the times. Government should take the lead in driving innovation through the establishment of digital government using the latest digital technologies. Thus, it is the time when your role is ever more important. Policies and cases for government innovation by the Korean government are included in this course. I truly hope this course inspires you and propels you to initiate projects with Korea. To help you build digital government policy, the Ministry of Interior and Safety and the National Information Society Agency have created the Digital Government Policy and Best Practice of Korea course. Its development involved 5 renowned professors in the field of e-government in Korea, as well as public officials in charge of digital government policy. To help you develop your digital knowledge and policy capabilities, we organized the course including ongoing digital government policy of Korea and various cases. The course included 15 chapters on 4 modules, which comprise the key success factors of the Korean e-government, infrastructure for e-government in Korea, digital government services of Korea, and digital government policies and best practices. Each chapter provides a video lecture and digital textbook. This is to help each student understand the core contents of the class with the video and then study further with the textbook. The first module is titled The Key Success Factors of the Korean e-Government. This topic will touch upon Korea's e-government policy, legal frameworks, in addition to changes and development in governance. This will allow students to understand what policy structure and components are necessary to build a successful e-government. The second module is titled Infrastructure for e-Government in Korea. It introduces infrastructure development processes and performances for an efficient and effective e-government system. Examples include an information network, e-government standard framework, and government integrated data center. The third module is Digital Government Services of Korea. Here, we divide Korea's representative digital government services into categories: Government for Citizen, G4C, Government for Business, G4B, and Government to Government, G2G. Outstanding services by category, as well as their performances, will be introduced. In particular, Korea's recent governance and services in relation to COVID-19 will be introduced. You will be able to refer to cases where the government and private sector collaborated to use public data and ICT. Lastly, digital government policies and best practices will touch upon the concept of digital government and digital transformation, which was triggered by digital technologies such as AI, big data, and cloud. It will also introduce Korean policy cases. We will also present issues that may arise when applying new digital technologies to public services and methods to count them. This will serve as a reference for students to plan and develop successful e-government services. The course specially provides lectures on preparing a digital government project concept paper, PCP, so that students can build e-government project planning capabilities based on what they have learned. This course will provide professional feedback on project concept paper by students, providing an opportunity to enhance their policy development capabilities. Countries that have submitted highly feasible plans will work on a project with the Ministry of Interior and Safety. I hope that Digital Government Policy and Best Practices of Korea course will help all students strengthen their knowledge and policy skills. Thank you.